friend to show.
Yo, what's going on, guys? It's your boy, The Golden Boy. Today, we are back on Modern Warfare Remastered. And today, what I have for you guys is a very, very highly recommended video. This is going to be the best ways, tips, and tricks to spawn trap on Shipment. Now, every single time you guys come into my streams, you ask me how I get Shipment so much, how I play Shipment so much, how we set up the trap, all these type of things. Well, first off, to get Shipment 24/7, you need to go into a lobby with a six-man party, a five- or six-man party. And once you go in there, you need to lobby surf until you see the actual map itself. And once you see the map itself, you're going to want to all vote it as much as possible. That's going to be your highest success rate of locking the map down. Now, what you guys see here is it's me and Impossible on C. There are two people top right of the map. So if you look at the radar, there are two of my teammates at the top right of A. There's one B runner, which is CompuShane, who's sitting in the middle of B flag, watching the roamers. When what we call roamers on C flag is this alleyway right here. These are the roamers. So CompuShane has our backs here so that me and Impossible can just keep rotating on and off of the C wallbang. And what you guys will see is, look, you guys can see we're getting massive feeds through the wall. Once I go to reload, Impossible goes to reload and goes to spray the wall. So once he's spraying the wall, I get back up, I start hitting the wall, he's down, he's reloading, he's getting ready, I keep on shooting. I got a massive clip, the PKM red dot, stopping power, deep impact, and bandolier is your biggest bet to hit C wallbang if you're doing that. If you're a B runner, you're gonna want a submachine gun. If you're top right, you're gonna want LMG, and if you're bottom, you're gonna want an LMG. It's your highest success rate of keeping these guys in the spawn. The biggest success rate that you want in this trap is to keep these guys in spawn. That is the main goal of the spawn trap for your maximum kills. So what we're gonna see is, like, airstrikes. People don't really know when to hit wallbang right now. So, like, right now I'm not gonna hit wallbang because there's an airstrike on top of us. They're gonna majority flip to right side. So we're waiting a second to hit wallbang. So you might as well not even waste your ammo. Now when I'm looking at my mini map, I see that it's clear on right side. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit the wallbang because it's all clear on the right side. After I'm done with ammo, I'm gonna go ahead and let Impossible spray as much as he wants. Grab a gun, run back. This is a private match, by the way, guys, so these guys kind of look a little bit dingly. They are bots. But the thing is with the airstrikes is people don't really know when to shoot wallbang a lot. Like, there's a lot of wallbangers out there that just spray like this. They're like, oh, okay, well, I'm going to get a bunch of kills. Like, that's not the case. You want to look at your radar a lot and see if your top teammates are in their spots correctly, pinning them down. This is going to be the most opportune time to hit wallbang, as you can see. Like, they're going to be a lot more spawning in the wallbang because we're forcing them into that one spot directly, and the only way they're going to spawn out of this wallbang is if they all spawn a majority at the same time, and then they're going to flip to the smaller areas, which they're going to be picked off by bottom right and top right. Now, another thing that you're not going to see in this video but does mess up a spawn trap a lot is them having martyrdom. Once they have martyrdom, they tend to spawn top side C, so top double dump. They'll spawn right there, right where I'm shooting. There'll be a few people spawning right there, because what martyrdom does is it prevents them from spawning on top of their martyrdom, so they want them to spawn somewhere else. The game doesn't recognize them to spawn in the same spot, so they want them to spawn somewhere else, so they spawn mostly top side C, which is where CompuShane is, or Impossible watches crossed if I call it out and I see that they're having a lot of martyrdom. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna go around the map here and show you where everybody is at. So Ball is Life is sitting in this crate right here, spraying these guys. They're only going to spawn right here and right there where Ball is Life is. He's going to keep spraying those right there. We have this one guy getting this other guy's back over here while he sprays. He sits behind these crates, or these, not these crates, these barrels over here. And he sprays the exact same spot where me and Impossible are spraying from top side. So he's spraying through here. Boom, 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 boom. They're going to spray right there. He's going to get the roamers while we're bottom C, so CompuShane's got this little area right here. If you guys would want, we could have this guy, the second guy on A, come middle, and he could watch just right here if he wanted to. If things are getting a little crazy with martyrdom, to keep them back in the spawn. And then you're obviously going to have us two sit on C, and Comp's going to go through B, through these little tunnels right here. He's going to go from top, check, check here. He's going to come through here, check here, clear it out. And that's pretty much it, guys. The way that spawns work on this is it's very, very heavily favored through C wallbang. That's why everybody wants C wallbang, blah, blah, blah. But when martydom comes into play, that's a big reason to where you need to split up and you need to communicate with your team. You can't all be on C wallbang. Only having two people on C wallbang is very, very efficient for this spawn trap, and that's why you see my entire team dropping a lot of kills. Like, it's not just me and Impossible. We have the most score, obviously, because we're getting to defend kills, but everybody's dropping high kills in this game. All right, guys, now we're back into the game. I'm going to show you the perspective of what it's going to be like when they have C-Flag, because a lot of people do not know what to do at all when they have C-Flag. So what you want to do is you want to stay away from C as much as possible. You want to stay away from C. You want to defend B and A, obviously, so you want to stay back here. They're grabbing C. You don't kill them. We're just waiting. We're letting them play the game that they want to play. And as soon as they get it, we're going to go, and we're going to rush to C. They're going to be spawning all around it. There's two spawns that they spawn on C. One right here, and one right here. Now, when Impossible gets over here, he's going to be in the corner right there. Impossible will be sitting. I'll be hitting wallbang. We hold him in through this right here. We also don't want him to get B too, but this is also just a little simulator that we're doing. Comp is still running B. We still have two people running top A. And we'll be sitting here spraying a bunch. And what you see there is Sunny came to here, came to C with us from top A. Because top A seems pretty clear, so he's going to come help us on C. The more people we have on C, the better. Because if we have three over on right side, three over here, we're able to trap them in the exact same spot the entire time. Now, what you're going to see is on the airstrikes is if they spawn top like that, they're going to wipe out the entire top. So they're going to spawn on C more because that's their home flag. And their spawns are a little bit weird right now because they have B flag. But their home spawn's going to be C flag. So they're going to want to put them on C flag as much as possible. So if we have airstrikes coming, like top right, like look, you'll see this airstrike come again, top. And they're going to want to spawn in these areas right here a lot more because it's their home flag. And yeah, that's pretty much it for C, guys. You're going to want to hold this area with 2 to 3 people. 3 people only if it's hectic. You can hold it with 2 for sure. We've done it many, many times with 2 people. Like right now, if that airstrikes, they're going to spawn them right side. Bottom right. And on C flag. So yeah, you've got to learn the spawns a little bit, guys. But that's pretty much going to be it for them having C flag. You want 2 to 3 people on C. 1 to 2 people top right. 1 person watching double or solo car, which is right side at all times. And you want a B roamer for keeping them off of B flag. But yeah, that is pretty much going to be the end of the video, guys. Hopefully that spawn trap does help you guys out, because I've been getting a lot of questions on how to spawn trap like the number one Modern Warfare Remastered player. I get it in all my streams, so hopefully that does help you guys out. If this tutorial does help you, make sure you do leave a like on the video, as it does help the channel out. Make sure you do subscribe too if you are new to the channel, because this is going to be a big channel for Call of Duty and Modern Warfare Remastered in general. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. We be sailing in the